The Aer Lingus, the Avalon Dragon, coming in to make a practice approach onto the beach here, the old Jersey Airport that you see slightly damply in front of you. So bringing you in now, we have Brendan Bruton is flying. He's an Aer Lingus captain, normally flies what he referred to as the Airbus A330. And here he is now coming in towards us, getting lined up, sitting there, and a practice approach onto the beach here. Yeah, from there he'd be able to get in. He'd walk away from that one. So the beach here is when you're in regular use. Amphibious flying boats used to land here for Imperial Airways, dependent on demand. If they had a few people that said we'd like to fly the Jersey Queen, then they would fly. But of course they couldn't have a regular timetable because they could only land when the tide was out, and they could only take off when the tide was out.
Indeed. And as aircraft such as this, the Dragon, the De Havilland made a number of very, very successful aircraft, such as the Gypsy Moth. They made a four-seater called the Fox Moth that was very good for hopping small amounts of people from A to B in a commercial manner. And a company in the United Kingdom called Hillman's Airways wanted an enlarged Fox Moth. So they took two of the Fox Moth engines, the same engine that powered the Tiger Moth, and they built an eight-seat cabin with the same wings as the Tiger and the Gypsy Moth on there. So they used a lot of existing pieces, and the net result was the Dragon, which turned out to be a very, very successful, very useful aeroplane. Although relatively lowly powered, a Dragon fully loaded could take off and fly on just one engine. Well, this is a very popular aeroplane, very successful here in Jersey as well. By the end of 1934, Jersey Airways had carried 20,000 showed aeroplane that is, the first biplane for the display this year. Indeed, now the prototype of these first flew at Stag Lane, the famous De Havilland Airfield, on the 12th of November 1932. And commercial operation started in April 1933. Now this could carry six passengers, each with 45 pounds, that's 20 kilos of luggage, from London to Paris, with a fuel consumption of just 13 gallons an hour. That's 49 litres an hour. That is very, very economical flying. Not only that, the wings outboard of the engines could be folded, so it didn't cost as much to store it in a hangar.
And in shares, photos out over Elizabeth Castle, this lovely old lady of the skies, and a real attachment to Jersey here. If you wind the clock back to the 1930s, what you are seeing now, right in front of you, would have been a regular occurrence. People came over from the mainland in the UK, also from France, to come to land here in Jersey. A certainly much more comfortable way of coming to the island than going on a boat, I'm sure. And certainly much more picturesque as you get to look down on everything as you go past. So here it comes from left to right, the De Havilland Dragon.
Indeed, now Aer Lingus, who operate this aircraft, took delivery of its very first aircraft, registered EIABI, on the 26th of May 1936, and they named it Iola or Eagle. That was the Irish Army Air Corps base just outside Dublin. And at 9 o'clock on the 27th of May 1936, the aircraft took off on Aer Lingus' first flight from Balfour to Bristol. So this is a very important aeroplane, not just in Jersey history, but certainly in Irish history. Now, just 115 of these aircraft were produced in Britain, and it was replaced by the slightly more elegant and slightly more difficult to fly De Havilland Dragon Rapide. But it was put back in production during the war in Australia because they had ample supplies of the engine because they were making Tiger Moths, and it was a nice, simple fix to get an aircraft. And some of these were built with a rear gunner's position. They made a total of 87 out of a total of 202 produced.
In fact, a new fighting dragon was delivered in 1933 to the Royal Flight and was used by the Prince of Wales. That was sold in 1935 and later impressed into service into the Royal Australian Air Force during World War II. Another dragon was called Seafarer, and that was operated by Jim and Amy Morrison. Of course, she had been Amy Johnson, and that was they made an attempt on the transatlantic record in that aeroplane.
From our left to our right. What a common sight that would have been all those years ago when people here in Jersey, as they waited for their relatives to come arrive here, or perhaps as they watched their loved ones take off and leave. That plane flying here before the Second World War. Quite extraordinary to think how things have changed in those times. Now we have our modern airport, of course, with its associated queues and things. Back in those days, in the 30s, you walk down the steps just in front of you, walk across the beach, dust the sand off your shoes, and get onto an aeroplane like that to take off to where you're going. How exciting that must have been.